Hi, welcome to Market Minute. This week we're going to look at the technology sector and try to find those next big stocks that are going to benefit from artificial intelligence. That's a big cycle and will probably last another 10 years, and we're probably in the early stages of it occurring. However, there's probably some really interesting ideas to play that are probably not well discovered at this point. Additionally, I want to hit on the technicals of the market. They stand out as a serious risk, in our opinion. And then lastly, what's going on in the bond market and what the Federal Reserve did last week. So technology, NVIDIA. Have you heard of this company, NVIDIA? They have 95% of the market share of specialized AI chips. They have gross margins about 10% higher than Microsoft's. So big gross margins, which means they don't have any competition. We do think NVIDIA is going to have competition. NVIDIA believes that there's $1 trillion of revenue opportunity by replacing all those central processing units with general processing units. That's probably about right, but it could take a very long period of time on doing it. What's unknown about the trend is how long it's going to take to do this, the acceptance of AI, and then the budgets to do it as well. Granted, Microsoft, Google, Amazon, and Meta have big budgets to do this. They might be getting somewhat maxed out on what they're going to spend on AI. And we wonder how much, NVIDIA's business is going to grow next year and how much competition they're going to see. At roughly 2.4 trillion market cap, and I'll show you a table in a second, it's not far behind the biggest company in the world of Microsoft. Microsoft sells at 34 times earnings. We think that's getting expensive. So if the market's using NVIDIA as a barometer, and as a barometer for the markets, we think we're getting into the very later innings in the near term. Looking at the table I mentioned, so we put together a table of what's important in our mind, what we're looking at. We have semiconductor companies here, NVIDIA, TSM, that's Taiwan Semi, AMD, Intel, Marvell, and then the mega cap guys. And then what's really important for AI is the memory and storage markets. So if you look at NVIDIA, 2.4 trillion, look at this table. Apple is at 2.7 trillion. Should NVIDIA have a larger market cap than Apple? Well, maybe, maybe not. Should it have a larger market cap than Microsoft? I don't think so. It's only 30% away of having a larger market gap than Microsoft. So can it get to the same market cap as Microsoft? I don't know. I mean, I doubt it. I seriously doubt it. What stands out to us is this 22 times enterprise value. So that's all the equity and all the debt. 22 times enterprise value to sales. That's higher than any of our companies on here. It's well beyond what a typical valuation is for a software company. You can see some of the comparables. Microsoft's at 12, and it's the highest on the list besides NVIDIA. I think Marvell's actually a short. I wouldn't own that stock. High PE, high enterprise value to sales multiple. AMD is a high multiple stock as well. It's riding off the coattails of NVIDIA. It's getting a 60 multiple and 11 times enterprise value. What I like on the semiconductor space, you can see Intel at 3.5 times. Okay, Intel is transforming itself. It's going to take a while, but we think over time it's going to get a similar multiple as you do with TSM at roughly 8 times enterprise value to sales. So it's got a doubling of plus growth on top of that as well, looking forward. Apple clearly has some problems. China is an issue, and their growth rate is just naturally slowing. We think there is a refresh cycle that's going to come with AI telephones. Not sure when that's going to be, but that'll probably be worth playing. Microsoft, as we mentioned, it's the king of all kings in technology. They are doing the best in artificial intelligence by far. They're gaining market share. It's selling at a discount to NVIDIA. And the market caps are very similar between those two companies, as I mentioned. Google at 1.9 trillion, Meta 1.3 trillion, Amazon 1.9 trillion. Should those stocks be selling at a discount to Nvidia? I don't think so. Micron is really starting to turn. We think Micron has a lot of upside potential, and I'll walk you through that. But just remember that memory and storage are critical components to these big data centers. To run on a PC, to run artificial intelligence on a PC, really full scale, you're going to need much better PCs than what we have currently. Even the smartphones, you're going to have to upgrade everything in the smartphones as well. So memory is critical, and that cycle is just starting to kick in. So if you look at Nvidia versus Micron, okay, there's something happening here with Micron, right? This is a 12-month chart. It's starting to perform very nicely. It's got a long way to go to catch up with the performance of Nvidia. So what is happening in the memory space is that these data centers require high bandwidth memory chips. What they are is basically DRAMs that are on a bigger scale that can handle more volume. And so what's happening is that those HBM chips are taking the capacity, the production capacity away from the DRAMs. So Micron produces both. Generally, all the major DRAM suppliers, there are only four around the globe that are producing DRAMs, are offsetting a lot of that capacity over to the HBM chips. So what's happening is that DRAMs are starting to go up in price, and you need lots of DRAMs in the smaller devices like PCs to be able to accommodate AI. So we see Micron over time, granted it's had a big move here, you can see this is something on our buy list. We like it. Western Digital, let me go back to that table. Western Digital stands out as what's wrong with this company. It's trading at 15 times in a hot tech space. It's only 1.7 times enterprise value to sales. They are going through a restructuring. They're going to split the company up in terms of the two business lines they have. I think it's a really interesting opportunity. I don't really know, exactly where we should be buying the stock, but we own a little bit of it, bought it recently. We think that there's more upside potential, a lot more upside potential in Western Digital. It should trade a similar multiple as Seagate, and maybe the whole group gets revised higher as people catch on to the cycle that's in front of us for memory and storage. So if you look at the technology sector, the old guys are coming back. Oracle is actually performing pretty well. Cisco, it has not, but we need connectivity in a big way to drive AI. Dell had a big pop on their latest quarter, so we think Hewlett-Packard, almost the identical company, it's going to catch up as well. They're going to start driving the AI as well, and that's going to have a nice move. So how to play big tech from here? You may have some core positions in Nvidia. I can't tell you to sell that because they're so on fire in terms of their business model. But own a core position in some of the leading companies and then circle back and buy some of these stocks that have not moved. That's where the performance is going to be over the next, say, 12 to 3 years out, in my opinion. It's going to circle back to these old line companies and play that memory cycle. I think that's going to be a really good play. The technicals of the market, they're so strong. So strong, they're concerning. So we haven't seen this type of move that we had recently in 20 years. So you can see where we are currently. We're 14% above the 200-day moving average. This is not a great indicator, but it just shows you where we are versus kind of a normal pace. So being 14% above the 200-day is high. The correction we had back in July, August of last year was roughly 12.5% above the 200-day. We had a really good size correction. So this big move here is unusual, particularly after having such a good year last year. So we're above the Bollinger Band, that's the yellow bands here. We're above the upper end of the Bollinger Band, which is unusual to be that high. So what we're thinking is, and the timing's uncertain, but what we're thinking is that we're gonna have a 5% correction back down to the green line of roughly 5,000 on the S&P 500 from 5,200 and change, roughly a 5% correction back to the 50-day. Who knows? I mean, the downside risk is all the way back probably to the 200-day, which, as I mentioned, 14%. Keep this in mind. My firm manages tactical portfolios. We start to get out earlier than the 200-day, but a lot of our competitors use the 200-day as a line in the sand where they will start to get out. So typically what would happen is using that, they might be down 16% before they start protecting portfolios. We think that's way too far of a drop. Now, interest rates. So the dot plots out last week, of course, something that the market was really focused on. The dot plots in terms of how many rate increases will occur did not change. It stayed at 3. So you had one more vote on keeping it at 3 cuts. So this is just a survey. It's not Fed policy. But one more than moving it to 2 cuts. We thought they would move to 2 cuts. So we think maybe on the next quarter, when we see this again, if the data is not good, they're going to move to 2 or 0. So likely they'll have an interest rate cuts in June. That's our thought, maybe July, but likely a cut in June. If you look at a major change in the dot plots last week was revising the GDP forecast from 1.4 to 2.1. That's a big shift. We get PCE on Friday. This is a key inflation indicator by the Fed. The core is what they look at. They focus on the core PCE, and they're looking for roughly, it was 2.8% last month. That should be down versus the prior month. Otherwise, the expectations are going to get thrown out. One thing that we are looking at, one thing that's really important for inflationary trends is oil prices. So oil is now starting to be above where it was a year ago. You can see at the bottom a year ago versus where it is now. And so this is the month of March here where I circled, and you were nicely above the month of March. And we're getting into a period where the year-over-year trends are going to be very positive for oil prices. So we'll have to keep that in mind. As we go through the year, we should get higher oil prices due to seasonality. So we'll see how that tracks versus the summertime oil prices itself. So just keep in mind, the markets technically are overextended. The valuation at over 21 times earnings is very high. The barometer for the market is NVIDIA. NVIDIA is stretched, so it takes a little bit of a leap of faith in the fundamentals at NVIDIA. Keep in mind, NVIDIA is not a reoccurring revenue model. They have to go out and create that revenue every quarter. Granted, right now they have a big backlog, but as they eat in that backlog, the stock is going to become increasingly more risky. So it's not a software play where a lot of it is recurring revenues. So the market barometer being NVIDIA concerns us, and we prefer to be more defensive at this point in the market cycle. So my overall philosophy is loss-averse investing, which means buy low, sell high. We are currently high, so just be on the lookout to protect your portfolios. Come to my website, Patrick Adams CFA, sign up to get a hard copy of Market in a Minute to be sent to you every Tuesday morning. And we appreciate you watching the channel. Please hit like and subscribe. Take care.